This is how a card looks like without a main event. Yes, we don't have a main event this weekend, but we do have two co-main events. Didn't get it? Let me explain. I'm gonna tell you what good fights are stacked in this card which you shouldn't miss. So hello everyone and welcome to the UFC book. A featherweight bout between former UFC featherweight champion Max Holloway and the winner of the Ultimate Fighter Latin America in featherweight division Jair Rodriguez was stated to serve as the event headliner. However, Holloway was pulled from the bout due to an injury. The pair is expected to remain inact and the bout will be rescheduled to a future event. Subsequently, co-main event between Islam Makhachev and Thiago Moises was then promoted to serve as the new main event. Number 9 lightweight Islam Makhachev is a rising star and a former Combat Sambo world champion. He has won 7 bouts in a row, most recently submitting Drew Dober on the pay-per-view portion of the stacked UFC 259 card. His MMA record is 19 wins and only 1 loss. He is a cousin and training partner of former UFC lightweight champion Khabib Nurmagomedov, so many believe Makhachev to be a future world champion who should already be in the title picture. He has called out a number of top 10 opponents, but because he wasn't in the top 10, none of them was willing to fight him. He was instead given this fight against then unranked fighter Thiago Moises as the co-main event of Holloway vs Rodriguez. But as you know, Holloway pulled out due to an injury, UFC postponed their fight. Instead of giving us a new main event of two top ranked fighters, UFC moved up both in lightweight rankings. Makhachev, who was number 14 when he beat Dober, is now ranked number 9, and Moises, who was unranked when the bout was announced, is now number 14. I don't say Moises is not a good fighter. The Brazilian lightweight is a tough fighter with a professional record of 15 wins and 4 losses, 4-2 in UFC. Moises is a former RFA lightweight champion and is on a 3-fight win streak of his own. He just got lucky to get a chance to headline a UFC event with not much impressive resume, and if he's able to play spoiler against Makhachev, he will immediately see himself placed into the title picture. But the odds are in favor of Makhachev, who already has more fans than many top ranked fighters. In the co-main event, women's MMA pioneer and former UFC bantamweight champion Misha Tate has opted to end her retirement and return to the fighting after almost 5 years. Tate, who hung up the gloves in November 2016, will make her comeback to the octagon this weekend when she takes on Marion Renault in a women's bantamweight matchup. If you are a new UFC fan and don't know who Misha Tate is, she is one of the biggest reasons you see women fighters in the UFC. Her rivalry with Ronda Rousey is still one of the most heated rivalries in women's divisions. Tate won the bantamweight title at UFC 196 with an incredible come-from-behind performance, putting Holly Holm to sleep with a rear naked choke in the 5th round of a fight she was losing. Tate is now 34 and hasn't won since that stunning performance. She went on to lose the belt to Amanda Nunes in her next fight at UFC 200 before losing to Pennington at UFC 205 in a fight that prompted her retirement from MMA. Her professional record is 18 wins and 7 losses. After the retirement, Tate became a mother of two and worked as an executive for ONE Championship. She was hired in 2018 as the Asia-based promotion's vice president, but this past November told MMA Junkie her duties had been reduced due to pandemic shutdown. She said she constantly trained along the way before finally deciding to make a comeback. Meanwhile, according to the report from ESPN, Renault, who at 43 is the oldest active female fighter on the UFC roster, will opt to retire from the sport after her fight with Tate. Renault told ESPN the bout with Tate will serve as her retirement bout. The veteran fighter and high school teacher suffered her 4th consecutive loss in her previous performance. Though she is on a 4-fight losing streak, she is an experienced fighter ranked as number 12. She has shared the octagon with many big names. Her most notable victory is over number 1 flyweight Jessica Andrade back in 2015. Her MMA record is 9 wins and 7 losses, while her UFC record is 5 wins and 6 losses. Well, there are 3 more undercard fights that you might find interesting. First of all, let's talk about Jeremy Stephens, who holds the record of most losses in UFC history, and trust me, it is still not the most embarrassing part of his career.
Who the fuck is that guy? Who the fuck is that?
Stephens started his UFC career in 2007 with a loss which broke his 9-fight win streak. His only victory over a notable fighter was over Rafael Dos Anjos back in 2008. He hasn't won a fight since 2018. He lost his last 4 fights from Jose Aldo, Zabit Something, Yair Rodriguez and Calvin Kattar. His opponent Mateusz Gamrot joined UFC last year as an undefeated with a record of 17-0. He lost his UFC debut by a split decision, but then he came back in April 2021 via second round TKO victory. So basically, if you want to see Jeremy Stephens breaking his own record of most UFC losses, you can watch this fight as well. Former UFC flyweight champion Deiveson Figueiredo's little brother Francisco Figueiredo, who successfully won his UFC debut by a split decision in January 2021, is coming back for his second UFC fight. He is on a 3-fight win streak with a professional record of 12 wins and 3 losses, while his opponent is on a 2-fight losing streak with a professional record of 12 wins and 5 losses. Number 14 ranked and former Jungle Fight strawweight champion Amanda Lemos is also returning to the octagon. Although she lost her UFC debut back in 2017, that's her only professional loss. She's on a 3-fight win streak now with a record of 9 wins and 1 loss. Her opponent Monserrat Ruiz is unranked and is returning to the octagon after winning her UFC debut by a unanimous decision back in March 2021. She is a former XFL and Max Fight strawweight champion with a professional record of 10 wins and only 1 loss. Now if you liked the video or enjoyed any part of it, do subscribe and share it with your friends on other social media platforms. We'll meet in the next video where I'll tell you how much Dana White paid UFC 264 fighters. So if you don't wanna miss that video, click the bell icon and turn on all notifications.